Australia. They're not only amazing artists, worship leaders, but they're amazing men of God as well. And so we're just blessed to have them. They won 5 Grammys and done some awesome things. We'll talk about that. But come on, Lakewood. First time ever to Lakewood for King and Country. You got to welcome them.
All right. Here we go. Well, good morning, Lakewood. It's lovely to be in your presence. Sing along if you know.
Texas, thank you for always making us feel so great. It's beautiful to be part of your family this morning. And what I love about church is you can walk in the highs and the lows of life, facing loss, facing joy. Maybe you found love, maybe you faced great loss. Yet there's room in the house of God for it all. Come as you are this morning.
Wide awake while the world is asleep, too afraid of when I show up by a dream.
Nobody, nobody, nobody sees you. Nobody, nobody will believe you.
And every try to pick up all the pieces, all the memories we somehow never leave you.
Nobody, nobody, nobody sees you. Nobody, nobody will believe you. Say, God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows how it's killing you. But there's a kind of love that God only knows.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows what they say about you. There's a kind of love that God only knows. There's a kind of love that there's a kind of love. Keep a cover over every single secret. So afraid if someone saw them, they would leave you. Somebody, somebody, somebody sees you. Somebody, somebody would never leave you.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows how it's cute.
Let me hear you sing it, come on.
There's a kind of love there.
God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they say about you. God only knows what's the real you. There's a kind of love there. God only knows. There's a kind of love there. There's a kind of love. There's a kind of love there.
Clothing has changed, but this summer story and the ones to blame. Or if you can start over, you can start over, you can start over.
Clothing
has changed,
but this summer story and the ones to blame. But if we can start over, we can start over, and we can start over. There's a count now, the count. What you've been through. God only knows what they see about you. God only knows the real you. No, there's a kind of love that God only knows. God only knows what you've been through. God only knows what they see about you. God only knows the real you. No, there's a kind of love that God only knows. There's a kind of love that there's a kind of love.
God only knows where to find you. God only knows how to pray through. God only knows the real you. But there's a kind of love that God only knows.
Brothers, I got to give you yesterday. Hey, take a seat if y'all don't mind. But we're gonna let them sing in a moment. I just want to. We're behind the scenes too, but take me back to how you got to America from Australia and all that.
Yeah. So we're originally born in Australia. Hopefully, you can still tell. The truth is, you Americans have jacked up my accent. So thanks. But born in Australia, our dad was a concert promoter in Australia, and on one particular tour that he brought back to Australia, the tour didn't go very well, and we ended up losing everything that we had as a family. We lost the house, we lost the car, we lost the life savings, and we were looking for, my dad was looking for a fresh start for his career, for the family, and he got a job offer in Nashville, Tennessee, and he thought it would be a good idea to move his 6 kids and his wife, who was 6 months pregnant at the time. And that's exactly what we did. But soon after we arrived in Nashville, my dad lost that job. And so we were stranded outside of the world, no friends, no family. We were sleeping on beds made out of clothes. We didn't have any way for our little sister to be born in a hospital. We weren't always quite sure where the next meal was going to come from. Didn't have any way. We didn't have a car at the time. And I've told that story, or that's some semblance of that story, for the last about 11 or 12 years, and we've had a lot of people come up and say, "Man, Luke, you guys should write a book." We should actually come to you for that, actually. You guys should, we should write a book. But the truth is, Joel and I were homeschooled, so we don't read or write very well, all right? And
shout out to the homeschoolers, we got you.
So we thought maybe we could make a movie instead. And look, the heartbeat behind the movie is really this. We believe in the power of family. I think power, that family is more powerful today than it ever has been in the history of the world. And Mother Teresa says this: if you want to change the world, go home and love your family. And that's really the blueprint behind the film.
That's so awesome. And you know, Joel, we were talking about how sometimes disappointments can still be the plan of God. It's not always a straight path. And you know, your dad, you know, losing everything in Australia, but who knows where you guys would be. But any thoughts?
Oh, there's no doubt. I mean, as Luke well said, when we moved, we had nothing, but what it caused us to do is fight for each other instead of against each other. Everything went back into the family fund. We raked leaves, we mowed lawns, we cleaned houses, and then our sister Rebecca and James started traveling and, to the over 40-year-olds who are familiar. So she started traveling and we became the road crew. I'm sure they broke a few child labor laws in the process. That really showed us so much about how the stage and being in front of the stage, behind the stage, on the stage, and taught us the impact of music, particularly music that's tied to the message of God. And so it was you would not have For King Country if it weren't for the struggle that we faced along the way. Hollywood Reporter said it well. They said, they were talking in the film, and they said it's turning struggle into an adventure. And I thought, what a cool omen for the Christian life, to turn struggle into adventure, you know?
Would y'all ever dream that, you know, you won 5 Grammys now and you sell out?
It's actually 4. You're being very generous.
I'm speaking about faith. I didn't want to
correct you, but I had to, you know.
We didn't edit it that time, so, you know.
Well, next time you're coming to be 22 or something like that. Anyway, enough faith for you.
Just keep going.
Favor the blessing, because you know, you guys were, you know, you didn't see yourself doing that. Y'all were touring with your sister Rebecca St. James, who I know, even though I'm 35, I still know her, but anyway,
no, crazy.
But you know what, you never know where God's going to take you. What'd you do? He called you one day and said, let's start writing some music.
I mean, look, I wanted to play basketball growing up. I am a little bit taller than you, Joel, but I want to play basketball. And my junior year of high school, I dedicated the last 2 years of high school. I was like, man, I'm going all in on this. I want to try and figure out if I can do this. And my junior year of high school, I was playing basketball. My very first game, was playing great, made a cut, and I tore my ACL on my left knee. And I felt like that was a way of God saying, I don't want you to play sports. And so soon after, I was actually talking with my mom. I said, Mom, everybody else in the family's got something that they're good at. You know, and the thing that I felt like I was meant to do was kind of taken from me, and I don't know what to do. And she said, look, by the time you graduate high school, I think there's going to be one thing left for you to do. And sure enough, I graduate high school, and Joel comes to me at that time and says, hey, man, what do you think about writing some songs and singing on some demos and just seeing where our music could take us? And we struggled even after that for about another 5-6 years. And then the classic story, one person heard a song and said, hey, man, what if we were to work together and you were to join this record label? And fast forward a few years, and now we're talking to you.
I love that. You know what it tells me, guys? God has the right people in your future. You may have a lot of no's, but you got to get through the no's to get to the yes. It just takes one person opening up that door. But I love that. So y'all made this film. Y'all produced it, and it's your life story. It's so inspiring. We'll show you a little clip, but anything we need to set up with?
Well, I will say this, just to set you up for what you're about to watch. I play my dad in the film, so I've dubbed it a very expensive therapy session. And as you said, Joel, Luke produced it, I co-directed it, and look, this is the definition of a passion project for us. It comes out in theaters around the country, about 2,000 theaters, on the 26th of April, and we've dubbed that Family Day. And look, it's a story about mums or moms. Moms. How do you say it?
Moms.
You sound like a herd of sheep. It's a story about mums and miracles and music. It's a 90s film. It's a true story. And it's a story about miracles. Like I said, speaking of miracles, they're both in front of the camera and behind the camera. One of the unexpected little God winks was... Adam Fogelson at Lionsgate picked the date, April 26th, and about a week later we're on the phone with our mum and we said, hey, mum, they picked the date, and she said, I said, it's April 26th, she said, oh, you know, that's our 49th wedding anniversary, right? And I lied. I'm sorry, Pastor. I lied. I said, yes. That's why we did it, mum. But look, we're awfully proud of it. One thing I will charge you with, and that is you are now our unsung ambassadors. With music, you have, I'm finding you have years to promote an album. And with theatrical releases, you really have one weekend. You have 72 hours. So we encourage you to come out on Family Day. And if you love your family, if you love your mum, if you love faith, if you love an overcomer story, it'll be there. And our hope ultimately is that mums were, you know, sons of a great woman, brothers to great sisters, husbands to powerful wives, but that we will rise up and call her blessed.
Mm. So good. I love that. So guys, it's April 26th, and you know, it makes a difference that opening weekend. You think, well, I'll go catch it the next weekend, but if it doesn't do well the first weekend, they don't get all those theaters back a lot of times. I mean, you get out of church. So April 26th, sometimes we're thinking, you know, there's nothing good in the theaters. Well, here's a great, inspiring message, and I just believe it's going to touch a lot of people. Because there are people that are going to a theater that won't come to a church, but they're going to feel God's presence in it. But we're blessed to have y'all with us. You want to sing some more, but should we take a look at the...
Let's take a look at the trailer.
Let's do it,
shall we?
Let's do it.
There we go. Backstage as to whether 8:30 or 11 o'clock would be our favorite, and I think you might take the cake for that tour.
You guys were very loved. Hey, if you're with your mum this morning, or your mom, would you reach out and hold her hand or give her a kiss on the cheek, show her that you love her. As we said, this film sort of celebrates the unseen, unsung moments of motherhood, but also we want to take a moment to sing over you, mums. If you've lost your mum or lost a little one, we're mindful of you as well. This song has the same title as the movie, Unsung Hero.
Once upon a time, you were 25, walking up the aisle. You made the promise of your life. You blinked twice and you were 29, singing lullabies. And I looked up at you for the first time. That's for sure, but I am sure there'll never be anyone like you. You're strong like your father, even when you were scared. When I was in trouble, you never left me there. And you love like your mother, like there's nothing to lose. You're my unsung hero. So I'll sing this song for you. Woke up, I was 21, and I fell in love. Remember how I told you that I'd see the world. You're fine for a girl, and all I see reminds me of you. You're strong like your father, even when you were scared. When I was in trouble, you never left me there. And you love like your mother, like there's nothing to lose. You're an unsung hero, and I sing this song for you. Times I fell down, you showed me how to stand. And when we crossed the ocean, you were my safe place to land. Been on a thousand stages, but when it's all said and done, I hope I made you proud of the man that I have become.
To be strong like my father, even when I'm scared. When someone was in trouble,
oh, I'll never leave from there. And I love like my mother, like there's nothing to lose. You're our unsung heroes, and we sing this song for you.
family. Thank you for this gorgeous story.
A bit more muscular than left because of all the... I don't know. Anyway, hey, can we stay together for this last one? On the recording, we have a choir on it, and I'm so thrilled to see a choir back there. But before we throw to you all, I want to introduce you to the Fakigi Country acoustic style band up here today. Would you make them feel welcome one by one? Starting with the Heart of Gold, Daniel Waterbury on acoustic guitar. Bringing the Latino flair on piano, Danny Lopez. And he just celebrated his 32nd birthday yesterday, our band leader, the perfectionist, Garrett P. Tyler. From the country of Texas, y'all, Vincent DiCarlo. That's right. And bringing the fierce feminine flair on behalf of all you ladies, she's actually married to Garrett P. Tyler. This is Hannah Tyler, everybody. All right, like I said on this recording, we have a 100-piece gospel choir, and I'm so thrilled to have you here. And I think we should add a few more thousand honorary choir members this morning. So, repeat this lovely three-letter word after us, like this. Everybody see?
Joy, joy.
Ladies after Lou. Okay, or after me, ladies.
Joy, joy.
Fellas after Lou, come on, go. Joy.
Joy.
Oh, put it all together.
Joy. Joy.
What do you think, little brother?
I mean, I think they're singing better than you and I are.
They're singing better than you.
Thank you so much.
You didn't even sing at all.
That's true.
All right, this song has a lovely three-letter title that you're never going to see coming. It's called Joy.
Lately I've been wheeling, watching the night waves. Don't seem to find the rhythm, just wanna sing the blues. Feels like a song that never stops. Feels like it's never gonna. Gotta get that fine line back in my bones. Before my heart turns into stone. Soon somebody please pass the megaphone. I'm shouting on the count of three, I'm with me. Well, I'll shoot my bed at night, I'll see it in the sky. Keep me straight to raise my voice, let me testify. Well, I'll shoot my bed at night, cause this is do or die. The time has come to make a choice, and I choose joy. Feels like the cycle never stops.
Sorry, hang on. I think the choir's moving great this morning. I think you can move choir a bit more, okay?
Feels like it's never
here we go.
Gotta get that fire back in my bones. Before my heart turns into stone. So I want somebody please pass me the megaphone. I'll shout it on the China three, shout it. Joy,
down in my heart. That's right, come on. Keep singing.
Lakewood, can you feel it?
Houston, can you feel it?
Can I tell you, your new week goes better when you put God first place and come to the house of the Lord.